Bam.
Okay, welcome to the Murray Cup 2016 Group D
Dire
playoff,
team
Purple Plate
bam.
playoff between Bell Clan and Vested Fame to settle who will go through into the lower bracket in the third position and who will go into the lower
Radiant
bracket in the
team
fourth
bam.
position. I'm General Jeevicus and I am joined by Atacon from Itari. He's going to give us a little bit of
Dire
insight
team
maybe
bam.
into what's going on. And
Will do if I get the camera work.
so anyway, first ban.
Which I am still struggling.
This OD first
10 seconds remaining.
by Bell Gaming, and they've Vested Fame though have banned out PA
Five
and
seconds
Windranger
remaining.
first, so presumably Invoker will get through.
Reserve time.
I'm hoping that's bans for their strats, otherwise that's a weird set of bans.
Or are they thinking about a Slark or a Sven maybe? But Sven's been banned out. But the Invoker will be picked up as they had first
Dire
picked the
team pick.
Bell
Faceless
Gaming
Void.
let it through.
Dire team pick.
That's definitely double G zero there.
Yeah, he'll. No, I don't know actually. They tricked me like this before.
Seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining.
Anti-mage.
That's a
Radiant
really early
team
pickup for
pick.
anti-mage, and there's a lot of counters left in the pool here, so I'm not so sure that's a great. Yeah, I mean, for example, Bloodseeker already just being
Radiant
picked up.
team ban. Dire team ban. Radiant team ban. Dire team ban.
No supports picked up on either team thus far. Strange way to draft, if you
Ten
ask me.
seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining. Reserve time. Dire team pick.
Lion.
Radiant team pick.
Shadow Shaman.
Dire team pick.
Sounds like Jeevicus might have crashed or is lagged out. Can't hear him right now. Finally, some supports being picked up by both teams. Shadow Shaman for the Radiant, good for pushing. Hopefully, with the Bloodseeker, they can secure some strong early lanes and potential
Ten
ganks.
seconds
Lion for the
remaining.
Dire. Good counter to Bloodseeker and a valuable Hex. Hex on both
Five
teams, in fact.
seconds remaining.
Be good to see an Aghs online, perhaps, for a Chrono combo.
Reserve time.
Pretty standard bans from Bell Clan, getting rid of the ODU, Spectre, and Sven. Furion, obviously, just in case they're a bit wary of the counter push. They were. Make space for anti-mage to farm up and be the carry that he was meant to be. Over on the Radiant, after those two strange first bans, they get rid of the Doctor and the AA, two really strong
Radiant
pushers,
team pick.
so perhaps we'll see a bit of a push strat coming out here with the Shaman and the Bloodseeker early on. Quap now picked up for Bell Clan. That's some good cap push with the ulti. And that's obviously her mid hero.
How do you feel about the matchup between Invoker and Queen of Pain mid there?
To be honest, most of the time Quap gets run over by Invoker. I mean, there's no way she can initiate happily with... I mean, obviously it depends on Invoker builds. If he goes Quasworks, then it's okay if she plays safe. If it's Spirits, then she has a really tough time in mid lane, especially with the Exhort. Like, last setting is not easy after level 3, 4.
She would need some mana regen to maintain
Dire team back.
This Ursa pickup, though, I mean...
Interesting drop with the Ursa here. I was thinking they need a bit more lockdown for the anti-mage, maybe. I mean, like, Legion is really nice there for those, but... Looks like Ursa's gonna be there, laning carry, and Bloodseeker will be in the jungle currently, unless he wants to offlane.
Maybe they pick up the Legion for the offlane. That doesn't leave much in the way of support, though. You'll have a position.
Yeah, it's a potential, but their early game was off.
10 seconds remaining.
I don't know. I mean, Ursa versus Bloodseeker in the jungle early. I have to give it to Ursa, I think.
Bloodseeker has the capability to farm without regen, whereas Ursa will need to go back to base a few times. I would say Bloodseeker is a better jungler, plus the lane ganking potential is much higher, so if it came down to a jungle off between Ursa and Seeker, then definitely Seeker takes that.
Radiant team pick.
That's a super strong last pick for them.
Yeah, it's
with the decrep versus Seeker and Ursa and potentially the right click Invoker, that's crazy good. And then the just another one to make sure Invoker can't do shit in a team fight. Really nice.
It's gonna hit Shadow Shaman pretty hard as well when he pops his Mass Serpent
Ward to level
3. Especially if he goes to fast.
I'm concerned about how Anti-Mage is going to play with the Void, because Anti-Mage being melee and that Chrono being really bad for Anti-Mage, I don't know how that's going to work out.
I think he just, they lay the Chrono down just before Humana explodes someday.
Yeah, I mean, he'll have to wait around it. It could be something really nice, like Void could go for an early Necrobot and burst people's mana down. I've seen that before with Diffusal Blade and Manta, and then Anti-Mage will pop an off.
Well. So we're going to see some serious mana drain. And Pugna's Ward drains mana as well.
Yeah, I would love to see a really big... Well, no, I'd love to see Necrobooks and Diffusal and Void.
Final pickup for Invested Fame. It's got to be another support, right?
I mean, I would hope so.
Maybe like, oh.
Dude, what is this? Triple jump? Oh wow! They're utilizing all parts of the map.
So if Doom goes offlane, there we go. Just
level 1 Roche. What do you? Well, it's going to be the CK jungle with the Iron Talon.
Yeah, I'm back. I love Lux so much. Yeah, so early Roche potential, I think is what the last thing I heard you say. And,
it turns out they're not doing it with the CK getting his early Iron Talon for the jungle. But would it be nice to see it? Hard to pull off, but really rewarding.
Yep, those level 3 on everyone's pretty sweet, and the extra gold obviously for support to early support items. Especially if you've got Invis Heroes or something on the opposing team. We are going to get smokes though.
Battle Fury Void as well. Looks like Bell Gaming is going for the wraparound in the jungle, hoping to catch off one of the Radiant, but they are as 4 and 5, so it'd be pretty hard to kill any. They're both fairly weak early game, they've both got like Lion and Shaman on either team, so they kind of, that's their only stuns really.
Smoke from both sides, they are going to go...
Smoke both parts, this is going to be ridiculous. Stun onto Ursa.
Ursa's in trouble.
Oh, okay, that's fast though, that's fast. They need to get out of here, Lion needs to...
Lion's
a bit of a misplay from Lion, getting blocked on the corner. They're just splitting up the team fight, if they focus, maybe they could do something.
The battle begins.
So one for one.
Almighty money.
One for one, yeah. Lion picking up the kill and Doom picking up the kill. That'll help Doom in the early game for sure.
Just having a go at Planetron here.
Worthy tribute.
Is this Doom farming them or? Strange how they've picked a Doom and into Ursa and also Seeker.
Well, Doom possibly, it's down to this camp being blocked. Where's the Bloodseeker?
Okay, so Ursa's rotating up top.
Bloodseeker's in the jungle.
I don't agree with this Ursa laning in the offlane. I think he's gonna get killed so many times. With the Pugner and the Lion, he's super dead. He's got the Shaman coming up as well though, and the Shaman Ursa lane is notoriously strong, so...
Yeah, it's a bit...
They'll have a bit of kill... They'll have a bit of kill potential with Anti-Mage having no stun, and Pugner not the... I mean, he has Decrep, so... If he uses it carefully, then they're not going to get anything out of this lane, but...
If the Shaman shackles Lion, though...
Yeah, that's when they can actually get a kill, but if Pugna decreps, then, you know, nothing's going to happen. So it has to be timed really well for us.
Yeah, maybe...
Bloodseeker is, unfortunately... Yeah, Bloodseeker's unfortunately finding out that all the jungle's blocked, so he's going to just move over to the medium and small camps. And get a bit of fun.
It's going to be a little bit more difficult for him. Anti-Mage though, picked off Shadow Shaman in the top lane
die by my blade.
Yep, no surprise there.
DC'd, we're going to have a small pause here. Just going to...
They're going to have to be very careful in that lane. Like, as the Lion gains a couple of levels, he becomes stronger and stronger. And with the Pugna there to save anyone who they might initiate on, any fight they take up top is going to get turned around real fast.
Well, Lion's going to drain hit point, mana. Pugna's going to drain hit points after level 6. And then Lambda's just going to hit his ult on the target with no mana. They're going to kill people. Doom's ahead on the net worth at the moment, but most last hits are the Void. We got a reconnection. I'm back into the action.
Yep, he's a... Over on the last six section, looks like Invoker's suffering a little bit for the early few levels, but he's choosing to go Quas Wex as well, so he's obviously going to have good regen against the dagger, but in terms of kill potential, he's going to be lacking a little bit.
It will give him
choosing to go
snap,
with a very balanced 1-1-1.
Yeah,
I mean, Cog Snap with EMP, if timed right, then yeah, it'll be good impact, but It's, I guess it's to make space for their team and just have a bit more control.
My gratitude.
Looking at the last hits section, Void's doing really well. Top of the leaderboard along with Quap and Anti-Mage at the moment.
Yeah, I just mentioned, he's getting a lot out of his lane, given the fact he's the off lane here.
He looks very comfortable in this hero.
Oh, Lambda gone again.
Looks like Anti-Mage is having a bit of problem. Right, well, I'm gonna go get my food, so I'll be back in like 2 minutes.
No worries. Gonna get this rune. Lane's in a pretty decent position to do that, I guess.
Well gotten gains.
Tasteless really taking a lot of damage, which is pumping the Bloodstreaker up. He'll be enjoying that.
Double damage!
He's got a double damage as well now. Blaine's run could be in trouble here. He's got 7 seconds more for his time walk. Bloodstreaker, meanwhile, just gonna take advantage of the extra damage. Still just has his only 650 gold. Really suffering for those camps being blocked out early on. Oh, hugging a ward here. Oh, I think Kenji Chris might be in a little bit of trouble here. Stun in a hex. Here comes the blink. There's going to be a few right clicks, but it's not going to be enough. Here's a final right click though from Lion, and he does pick up the kill in the end. Pugna pretty passive throughout that engagement. His boots picked up on Doom. Lots of last hits here for B twice. Queen of Pain though dominating the mid significantly. 23-2. Blobs FS Crazy on the mid once again.
Dire's bottom tower is under attack.
Creep wave pushed up, but here it is. Blobs F Crazy. He's gonna get doomed up and silenced. He's gonna be in a little bit of trouble here. Should wear off just in time. No Chronosphere to save the day from Blanestron. He's gonna have to back it off. So a bit of an early rotation, misunderstanding of the positioning of the enemies there does throw the fight the way of Invested Fame. 486 to XP, 575 to gold. We have a look at the net worth, see how that's affected things. Doom very much ahead. 2600.
Dire's middle tower
he
is
will
under attack.
Be picking up a blink dagger fairly soon. No, he's actually going to go for. Is he going for a Vlad's first, perhaps? So, Ursa won't fill May. Vlad's first. Lord goes the way of Kenji Chris there, picking up some easy gold. Bob's FS crazy nice smoked.
Dire's middle tower is under attack.
Looking for Bloodseeker or Ursa. Catch him on low health. He is actually on low health here.
Hello, I'm back.
Double back. Hey, man.
Oh, look at bot lane. Doom getting got on by Quap. Ah, confirmed kill.
Getting wrecked, yeah. Faceless Void pick up the killing blow there. I mean, Quap and Faceless very much tied as for third and fourth.
Dire's middle tower is under attack.
He didn't even need to chrono for that, that was just a straight up burst down kill.
Now Ursa in trouble here at top.
Yep, another confirmed kill.
Though, there is gonna be an invoker plus Shadow Shaman Kali.
Radiant's bottom
and that's gonna be a dead
bug. Nice kill
confirmed from invoker there. Yeah, surprisingly. They've both got really strong ward runes on both sides of the map at the moment. It'd be nice to see an aggressive lane ward from either side.
Yeah, maybe something around about here. Oh, hang on. God damn it, man. I can't draw on the screen when it's paused.
I can see it. You mean around here?
Yeah. Oh, I see it on the map. Yeah.
There, right?
Just here. Yeah,
yeah,
here.
I can draw on the map, but on the ground.
Maybe down here. Get one in here. One here. Or I actually quite like it as well, if you can get one in and around this area anyway. And then get this one as well at the top.
Ooh, I just realised, I can see your, like, camera view on the map, but I still can't follow it, so, meh.
I don't know how it works, really weird. On. Generally just focus on where the action is anyway.
Yeah, pretty much.
Not quite sure what the pause
is. Let's keep it going. I think Anti-Mage is his internet's being pretty bad.
Ah, oh, he's DC'd there. Okay, fair enough. Yeah, not much as far as items up for either team yet at the 6 minute mark. We do have Doom did pick up Phase Boots, Ring of Basilius. He's got a Ring of Regen as well, so presumably that's going to go into a headdress. And we are going to see a Vlad's pick up for him. So I'm not sure what Kenji Chris will build for Lifesteal. Possibly Dominator into Satanic, maybe? Double G just has his bottle. Invested Fame. What's his name? Spang? Oh, I don't know.
Spaghetti Lord?
Spaghetti Lord, yeah, Spaghetti Lord though. Only got his boots, man. Six and a half minutes. Level 5 though. Hasn't quite managed to find that level 6 before 6 minutes in the jungle there. Despite the Iron Talon pickup. Basically because those two cards were blocked.
It'll be really valuable if you can get that and start ganking out Doom's lane to try and get a kill off the Void. But as long as that Chrono's up, that's never going to happen.
Yeah, they don't really have much ranged potential. I mean, obviously Invoker can really mess things up when they're in the Chronosphere. His spells will go through it, right?
Yes, they do.
A Shadow Shaman, I guess, once he's about level 8 or 9, maybe 11, 12, he can do Aethershock. The Burning, the Chains, the Shackles does do a little bit of damage, though. It's not bad, actually, 368 max level.
That's decent, yeah. I'm not sure how Invested Fame's early game is going to go. I mean, with these block camps from Vel Gaming, and then I know the Doom's getting some decent farm, but he's been ganked once already, and I'm pretty sure Quop's going to keep targeting him as the game moves on. Doesn't seem like they're getting much out of the jungle from the Bloodseeker. Doesn't seem like the Ursa Shaman lane is going that well, so I feel like they're going to suffer for the next 20 minutes or so until Doom, like, you know, gets his Ags and refreshes up or something. And Invoker gets some big items as well.
Ursa's farm is really bad.
Yeah, I mean, the good news for them is that I think they have the upper hand once it reaches 20-30 minutes because of the Doom taking out Anti-Mage, Bloodseeker taking out Anti-Mage. Once they all come online, that guy is going to have a really tough time. I think the question is, can Void and Quop buy enough time for him to become that six-slotted monster that we all know that Anti-Mage can become? And right now, I think the answer is yes, so I guess we just wait and see. It looks like the players are getting a little bit fed up with the pause, but only natural.
Yeah, I know. Not much we could do about it. Oh, Christ. That's a nightmare scenario.
Right, I'm gonna go get my Kiev and probably another Fab.
Sure, man. Only three effigies. On invested fame. Must be alt accounts. Playing as Sean then, he's gonna pick up Tread next, I guess. What have we got gold wise? What are they sitting on? Current gold. Invoker on 891. Let's hope we can see what he's up to. He's got a bottle and a null talisman. I mean, I figure he should finish boots, maybe get phase boots. On image, I guess he's got the Ring of Health, so I guess he finishes in Perseverance next. Lion just going to pick up his Tranquils. Boots finished for Bell Gaming at all yet? I think the net worth is fairly even. 252 invested fame. Those fights, 250 swing overall. And it looks kind of like that graph is going up a little bit. Bell Gaming though, staying steadily ahead of invested fame on the old XP and levels. Let's check out levels. Yeah, well, we got Doom Invoker on level 7, so we got 2 on level 7 for invested fame. Yeah, I noticed the camera was moving, I was like, what? Hero selection even. And then Void and Queen of Pain also on level 7. And then it's all, well, I mean, level 5 on the Bloodseeker, so they're getting slightly more, it seems, in levels wise out of invested fame. Just very slightly, but I mean, Ursa's paying the price. Still level 3.
They really need levels on the set, so if they want to get a decent time with Roche as well, then, you know, maybe. It's weird that they could even rotate Bloodseeker up top now and let Ursa jungle.
Ursa doesn't have Morbid Mask though, which would really help a jungle.
I mean, he's level 3. It wouldn't take him long to get the Morbid Mask.
Oh dear. I guess, you know, checking for updates before turning up to play. They're pretty random, I guess. Still fairly passive, 1-2 wards each. No stack jungle camps.
Do it, join the memes.
Oh, they'll be so disappointed.
I've got a great game. Let's make meme jokes out of every single one of these guys' names to pass the time. Oh, here comes Anti-Mage with a reconnection. Hopefully all this stuff is sorted.
My thanks.
I'd like to see a smoke if they were going to be doing this much of a push at top. Oh, EMP and tornado. Gonna be having a little bit of a problem for Pugnat top here. There is a TP in though from the Void. This could be a real terrible situation. Ooh, for them.
Really nice crown onto.
No follow-up damage, no ranged as we discussed before.
Invoker seems to just run away with costs. I think he'll get a...
He's gonna try TP.
Gets he TP makes it, yes. Okay, so... Under attack. Dire's bottom tower, I guess under it's back to farming, because... That was a bit disappointing. No kills going either way.
Hit points, a lot of mana, a lot Radiant's of middle tower is under attack.
Dire's bottom tower is under attack. Bloodseek has finally hit his level 6, so it'd be nice to see him just come out of lane and kill basically whoever comes to the off lane next.
Well, basically, I like to rupture whenever it's off cooldown.
Yeah, I mean, that's the way it should be played, really, just a global presence, keep a TP on, and then go kill people.
Yeah. Oh, another big EMP from Poker at top, but they are going to blink out. Mother King is going to be so lucky, the Ursa Shadow Shaman combo is just kind of, I mean, he didn't need it. Like, Ursa hit him like once and he was dead, so.
Dire's bottom tower is under attack.
One of the great strengths of the Quas Rex is that you have two basically self-sustaining spells after level 8 every 30 seconds, and that's a big help. Invoker's now a Ghostwalk to move up past that ward which they had for the rune, and I don't think they saw him, so this should be a really good initiation if they can get off.
There is a ward move, careful how much it goes down.
Radiant's middle tower is under attack.
Gonna get the line on
it looks like Invoker's gonna pick up.
And then Ursa's trying to go down as well if we get a cold snap.
Invoker's got 5 seconds till the next TP. It's under the next spell. He's gonna have to decrypt, but the tornado's gonna come out. Oh, just missing him. Anti-Mage no mana though, Invoker's just right clicks. Yeah, I think he thought he could do more damage.
Blob's F crazy was closer.
Oh, that was right on the edge. That was really close.
So I mean overall 499 gold, so 250 gold exchange and 650 XP going the way of Bell Gaming for that queen kill there. The kill on the queen. By the queen.
Looks like Seeker's now farming a minus. Strange that he's doing it after treads, but okay.
Not a fan of Midas builds on Bloodseek.
Nah.
No evil.
I like to get blade mail first, generally. Unless I'm like 8-0 by 10 minutes, and then I'll probably pick up a Radiance first.
Doesn't matter what you get at that point.
Yeah. You just gotta be worried about, if you've got that many kills, generally it's because they've got like game carries that you've been able to just like destroy along with their supports.
Doom picking up the early blads, choosing to go for only 2 points in Scourge Star. Interesting.
It's gotta be some combo with the Ursa.
Quop's blinked in. Chrono is available. And he will now use it. He's gonna burn to death though, if he's not careful.
Oh, he's out though. Time walks away. And
they wanna go on him, but Bloodseeker's now in the room. He looked for the rupture, but she blinked out.
Queen of Pain, obviously, when her blink is maxed, can just about dodge the rupture.
Yeah, he's not gonna find anything here. Invoker and Quop now building Orchid each. Quop's slightly further ahead, but Invoker's also got phase on top of that. Choosing to pick a bottle as well this game.
Yeah, I think it was mid though, right? So it makes sense.
Yeah. I mean, it's pretty rare to go bottle in Invoker, but it's not a bad thing. If you want map control, then going for Rune. Yeah, yeah. It's not a bad thing. Like,
and popping your runes when they're more advantageous to yourself on Invoker is pretty good, especially if you've got any kind of points into Wex. Double damage can be pretty sweet. That Arcane Root is.
Dire's middle tower is under attack.
I'm still really concerned with this Ursa and the lack of farm that he has. Oh, that was a big misplay. He just went too deep. He wasn't aware of the shackle and played with his life.
Oh, there's gonna be a doom though. Onto the void.
Good rotations. Chrono completely unavailable.
And the line goes down on the back side of that as well. Anti-Mage looking for some cover. He's just going to TP out. Invoker going to try for the turn.
This is some really bad hit. Rupture available. Doom can't really do much anymore though.
He can look
scary,
I guess.
He needs to make use of this. Hopefully this is the tower.
I mean, he should just rupture Boomstick.
Dire's structures are fortified. Dire's
not sure he has the vision.
Dire's top tower has fallen.
I don't know.
Radiant's middle tower is under attack.
Nice though, playing it by the numbers, just kind of taking
Radiant's bottom
tower
is under attack.
Not pushing too deep. Vision really poor on
the map at the moment. It's spotted out Invoker. Hex onto Invoker, anti-mage rock clicking away. The stun to follow. Oh, fingered and mana avoided. Yeah, he's a dead man.
I can't die.
600 gold going the way of the line, and anti-mage picking up some good and valuable XP and AoE.
Yeah, his battle fury is coming along nicely as well. He chose to go for the broadsword first rather
Radiant's
than.
Radiant's bottom tower is under attack.
I'm okay with that. I think his lane's been pretty okay.
The standard way to build the battle fury is to go for the claymore so you can buy the broadsword from the side shop, but whatever works.
Yeah, I would have picked that up from the side shop. Just claymore, I guess. But I normally like to get.
Dire's
like
structures are fortified.
Yeah, depending on the farm, it would have been better this game to go for that. The lane wasn't so easy.
Radiant's bottom tower
is really
under
easy,
attack.
So, I mean, he can just do whatever he wants.
Chrono on three. No follow up yet, though. Quop's blinking in. Ulti in 5 seconds. Shackle onto void.
There's a rupture as well. He's on the wrong target,
bro. Oh, he manages to get out. Health regain.
He does have double damage.
Yeah. Once again, she's just too far forward with the blink. There's no follow up.
Oh, nice. Shadow Shaman is still looking for more, but in double G's here as well on the Invoker. That Cold Snap is down on Bugna.
Radiant's bottom
he is
tower
now a fish.
Is under attack.
I'm not sure he's gonna get them.
I think he could throw a Sunstrike, but I mean it'd be pretty weak. He's gonna try it.
Radiant's bottom
It's only level 2, I'm not sure he'll kill. None
no, but
that.
He did have the Decrepify on, so he would have taken the extra damage.
Yeah, I'm not sure why he'd be decrepping there though.
Invoker right click, he's scared of it.
Dire's middle tower is under attack.
This is the reason why Quop's like really quite squishy is if she makes one big misplay with that blink, you're going down. Like there's no way you're gonna survive if you blink in the midst of 2-3 people. And she kinda whiffed the ulti, only really hit Shaman, I think it was.
What do you think about Blob's FS Crazy maybe picking up Blink Dagger after Orchid?
Blink Dagger on Quop?
Yeah, so
I mean,
I've seen
crazier thing. The thing is, she shouldn't need to have a blink dagger. If she's going blink, then it means that she's not using her blink right. I think it's a waste of, well, not a waste. I think it's There's better things you could get, more economical items. Like a Lincoln Spear would be her ideal bet. Stop the Doom, stops the Orchid Silence, stops the Rupture. There's so many there's better things than the Blink, basically. If her role was to blink in and...
In this game.
Yeah.
Rupture. Doom.
He's just gonna walk away. They're in a bit of trouble here. 4v2. Doom's coming in from the side. Shackle onto Lion. Instantly be stopped.
Oh, lovely. By big stream.
Lion doing the right thing and staying there to the end. And Invoker's going down as well.
So, 3-1, pretty good trade, I have to say. Two carries, I guess. Well, I guess it's not. Doom was the main farmer, right? Yeah, second highest on net worth.
Investor Fate really were not expecting three people there. Under attack. Yeah, more tower going in the way of Belgae. This Void looks like he's picking up drums. Structures are fortified. Quops almost got Orchid now as well, so a bit faster than Invoker after he died twice already.
He does have a fair bit of gold though, so his second Oblivion Staff will come along shortly.
Radiant's top tower is under attack.
Also could go Roche now, and I think he needs to just smoke up and go for it. They need a bit of an advantage, and he definitely needs to go Roche soon. That's the smoke, so yeah, he's thinking about it. Chrono down for 60 seconds, so there's not a huge amount of lockdown right now in Belgaven, so if he chooses to go now, it's a really good time.
Arcane Rune just sitting here bottom.
In fact, all three choosing to go and smoke up. This could be dodgy. No, Quops walking back to mid lane. Looks like they're gonna get it just fine. They did see the DD get taken though, potentially, so.
What's secret to Blood Rage?
Looks like it's being pointed out, maybe? No?
She Blood Rage
might just get away with it. Yeah, you should.
So sick.
There's a smoke up from Bell Gaming, but they're completely unaware and they instead choose to go on the Doom. Yeah, he's bursted down. No chance for him. Shaman's gonna go down as well.
Oh, he got a ward though on the Blob's F. It's crazy. He can't blink out of it though, so no real danger.
Damage from Invoke is massive. 200 per right click. He's got Tornado. Lion's salving up.
He does have
Tornado hits.
On the Invoke. I think
he's got the Aegis as well, so he's got Aegis. He's not scared.
Yeah.
If he can escape, it's really worth it.
Nice
but
bait
he's going
silence.
Down. Once again, Quap hits with a life.
Bloodseeker is so much damage from all the slow health.
Definitely on two. Lion's being right clicked to crap on Punk. Ursa's got no mobility.
He needs
but
to move
he might be
way.
Able to catch. Top tower is yeah, he's
yeah,
going for it, but
Bloodseeker
might pay. Invoker's just going to go talk away.
Yeah.
He'll be fine. Nice play there. Nice.
3K
Battle Fury, Battle Fury and Advance finally finished on the Antimid.
Dire's middle tower is under attack.
Looks like Ursa's going Shadow Blade this time, right? Not Blink Dagger. I think Blink would have been more effective just to escape from Chrono and the silence from Quap, but
they have so much mobility.
I guess Shadow Blade does the trick. Yeah.
Generally, a Shadow Blade makes the supports more likely to buy a lot of sentries, and then you start losing your ward vision as well.
Yeah, it's true, but the supports in Belgaming tend to be a bit better off. With Pagna already got his arcanes working on the Ethans, and Lion's already got his Blink, so I don't think it'll be too much of a problem, really.
Decent situation to be in.
Regeneration!
Oh, fighting mid. Lobs FS crazy.
I mean, the thing is.
Again.
Yeah. He's paying for it, apparently.
Orchid finished on the Invoker as well, yeah.
Doom on anti-mage. Ooh, he's burning. Good stop from Lion, needs to get away.
It's on strike. Not so sure he's gonna live. Here comes Bloodseeker with Rupture, I think.
Again. You'll die as you lived. He's 3 down for Bell Gaming. I'm starting to think Invested Fame is gonna pull away.
Well, I don't understand what Bell Gaming were doing there. That was foolish.
There was no need to be there, no way.
I don't mean it's just getting a little Dire's middle tower is starting under attack. Well, I mean, Queen of Pain getting greedy in mid. Pushing mid, Anti-Mage while on the Ancients gets picked off.
Anti-Mage needs to farm a really fast mantle.
Yeah, he
needs that mantle right now.
Dire's middle tower has fallen.
He only has the Blade of Elvenkin, or whatever it is. So, I don't know.
Looks like Void's saving for Blink Dagger. I'm inclined to imagine he'll sell his Van Talon and pick it up shortly.
Yeah, I think that's a decent pickup. Just gives you a very large Void Chronosphere range. Oh, Bloodseeker getting caught out.
Oh no, he's been spotted out.
Somehow dodges.
He
the
needs
screen.
To get out there.
But I mean, there's not much you can do. No blade mail, no, on Bloodseeker.
Anti-Mage also gonna get caught in this. Anti-Mage mana all gone. Not sure if Invoker notices, but the TP rotations are in and they're both gonna get away. Or maybe not, maybe if there's
a huge bit of damage. Well.
Tornado? Tornado connect. And that's another kill. Lion with his stun and Invoker's just saying, yep, I'm just gonna TP it.
Oh, fingered Annie just TP.
Really, really nice play there, just knowing that there was nothing they could do to stop him TP.
Definite advantage going the way of Invested Fame now, despite this lineup.
Smash is getting pretty close to the Shadow Blade, that will help a little bit more.
Shadow Shaman just picked up a mech as well.
Yeah, Invoker almost got his Aghanim's, another 1k. Doom going 4 drums, so another drums. Solid
nice,
mid-game item.
2,800 gold, I think he's going Radiance.
Could be Radio, could be Blink, could be X. Be interested to see what he picks up.
He'd be saving for buyback though, I guess.
Nah, I don't know. You won't need to save for buyback.
No, I mean, the lanes are all in their favour, so, well, mid's getting a bit pushed, but I mean, there's no real danger at the moment from an attack by Bell Gaming. They just want to farm Anti-Mage.
They need to deal with this Invoker. They need to just have a couple of sentries out, because every time someone comes to the jungle, it's another kill. They need to roam in pairs of 2 or 3 at the very least. Ghostwalk debuff hits Lion for a second, so they know he's around. And Lion's got a couple of sentries on, so Invoker just backs up.
Right here.
Yeah.
And well, the Ghostwalk's down.
Void TPing bot? Oh, just missed a kill on Quark.
Yeah.
Looks like Sheba's doomed up, so no getting away for her.
Yeah, plus Ursa, I think, was the one hitting her. So, well.
Quap's choosing to go for Aghanim's this time round, and I would say it's quite sensible, given that soon enough they're going to be defending higher ground at this rate.
He's not going to get the Shackles in time, though, and Anti-Mage is just going to blink away. No, he's going to try for...
Oh, no.
Oh, that's a foolish move.
He's... That's an idiot.
There's a Rupture on a Lion, he's just going to run it off.
Okay, maybe he didn't notice, but yeah, he could have stopped outside there. Void's finally picked up his Blink deck. Bloodseeker, having farmed quite fast, Midas, Sanjin Yasha sitting with 1.6k gold.
I think he builds BKB next, or maybe a Mjolnir, or a Deso.
I imagine it would be BKB. But then again, I mean, they have Chrono, they have pure damage from Quark. I guess it's just to stop, like, Pugner and Lion doing anything to him. He can just run at people
yeah,
and clear.
Yeah, nobody likes to be locked down and no boss.
Nope. Chrono onto Invoker top.
I don't think he's got the damage.
Time dilation a bit early, though, and he's just gonna walk away. Lion blinking in that. Good for the thing. Invoker take it.
Radiant's middle tower is
I think
Sire
Badass in a little bit of trouble here as well, but they're gonna just let him go. It's just lucky they have
I think they get a chase. Yeah, I think they get a chase.
They just want to farm the Anti-Mage. Bloodseeker overtaking him on farm now, though.
Yeah, that mine is beginning to pay off. And it's going to be BKB for him, so...
Yep, yep.
That's going to be a big problem for the casters on Bell game.
Where the hell did I go?
Doom Invis is here. Quop kind of abandoned the Ancients, but... looks like Light could be a pretty easy pick-off if Doom wants to. Yeah, right, he's going for a Raidy, so he's just picked up the Relic.
He's gonna go for a Doom kill on this guy.
He's gonna spot out Void there. And he's chosen Void as the top. I'm pretty sure that's a dead Void. That's a dead Void. They've got no heals or anything, but we'll see what Doom has. What happens to Doom?
He's got so much damage. Ooh.
Just an underestimation from Quop.
Damage right clicks.
Yeah, with that alpha wolf, he's dealing a serious amount of damage there.
Yeah, nice 200% crit damage, 520.
Radiant's top tower is under attack.
Anti-mage back on top of net worth, but I still feel he's lacking a little. He needs at least Manta and one big item before they can take a genuine fight.
Yeah, if Bloodseeker wants to stay ahead on farm, he needs to be murdering people rather than jungling. You can't farm as fast as a Battle Fury anti-mage. Blink, Battle Fury. He's got the Yasha now as well, so he's got his movement speed increased. I think Bloodseeker has Sanji and Yasha though, right? Yeah, he did pick that.
Well, finding the Shaman instant silence, but nothing to follow up, so... Once again, he gets to walk away. Oh no! Lion's found.
Yeah, he's just gonna go.
He chooses the wrong way.
Exploratory EMP, but they're thinking the better of it.
Yeah, they weren't happy taking that fight. They knew there were five people.
It's great space though for Ursa in the bottom lane and yep. Doom.
Roshan back up now. They're in a prime position to take it as well.
Dire's bottom tower is under attack. Dire's bottom tower has fallen.
They got so much space to work with here. This area here they can't TP into. There's gonna be a response from Blamestron though, that could be unfun in the Rosh pit.
Almighty money.
I'm sure they know. Anti-mage getting caught by invokers, tornado followed up by silence. Lion's here to save the day though. Stun.
Looks like they're gonna turn it around.
They're gonna kill him.
Get thee to the underscape.
Yeah, this is exactly what Bell Gaming need. They need solo target pickoffs on the guys who are high on net worth. And right now Anti-mage is beginning to pull away, so if this carries on then they stand a really good chance of being able to make that high ground defense. And
once he gets his start pushing back, things are going to speed up even more for him.
Doom is a really big problem for Anti-Mage though. They have to genuinely team up and take him on as two or three. There's no way that any one of them can kill him.
Oh, Dust on Ursa, he does get caught with a stun. There is the Scream, followed up by the Finger. Oh, everything used to blow him up, and Rob's FS Crazy is going to definitely pay for that here.
That's a fine trade though, that's still good.
Yeah. Not much stacking going on. Just the Morbid Mask still on Kenji Chris there. I think he'll upgrade it later or?
There's not really much need to upgrade it really. He could go the RTZ build and go turn it into a Mask of Madness or go dominate them for a bit of armor, but I think right now as they're ahead he may as well just keep it as it is. Invoker getting a little bit caught out there.
He's just gonna go down. Yeah, they get silenced. So what?
That's Anti-Mage finally coming online for you, that Manta doing work. Doom going in hard. Stun from Lion hitting 2. I'm not sure there's any follow-up to that Doom.
He does have a Doom on the Void, but Void's probably going to be okay, I think. Yep, he just survived.
Nice stun from Lion.
Oh, Bloodseeker a little bit.
Race kind. He's sitting on 3k as well.
I mean, what do you think he picks up next?
Well, there's the answer, Chandler. Yeah. Interesting. There's 2 Shadow Blades. I mean, looks like they're smoking out. They're gonna go maybe Roshan. That's a really smart move if they decide to go right.
Well, there's no wardage from Radiant here, so they're going to be completely unaware. And it should go down pretty quick.
Not the fastest rush, but it's going to go down before Invested even realise that it's going on.
Going to maybe trade two.
This is also what
top,
they're... They're playing this really smart.
They should be able to go down and take a tier 2 bottom in response.
Roshan has fallen to the Dire.
TP rotation's coming in. Oh, Quat baiting out of the tornado. Very close though.
Tower just gonna go Dyer's down though, top under tower the has assault fallen. Of Invested Fame.
Oh, nice. Chrono on 4. Anti-Mage clicking on the
with
background.
The screen,
oh, with the ulti.
They're still going to get some kills out of it, but...
Meatball on 3, a lot of damage coming up.
Invoker taking some damage from the cleave there. Oh, Anti-Mage, I'm not sure you're strong enough. He does have the Aegis, though.
Why get hunted by
the Radiant's burn doing some work. He doesn't know, though.
He's looking for Invoker, I'm not sure he's going to get it.
Ah,
doing with Anti-Mage, he's going now.
There is no magic in death.
Well, they get the top tower at the cost of 3.
I think worth. A little bit of damage done to the ranged racks as well. Yeah, the Anti-Mage got a lot of.
Dire's middle tower is under attack.
Doom going heart next, I think. What do you think of Ags Atos on Doom?
Ags Atos? Oh my goodness. I don't think it's that great because two of them are blinked, Lion has blink, Punk has got Decrep, and Void's got.
No, not in this game, not
Void's
this game,
got Time
in general.
Eh. I'm not a fan of Atos on Doom. I think it's a bit of a wasted item.
I don't know, I quite like the slow with the perma, perma ult.
I mean, I guess if you're playing a solo game it's alright, but in general if you just go blink someone, hit them in the Infernal, ulti and then Scorched Earth, you're gonna kill them regardless. And Doom gets improved move speed with Scorched Earth and phase, so there's no problem with chasing, so... I think I'd rather have a blink to chase than an Atos to chase.
I suppose you could get Shivas as well.
Yep. Shaman looks to be going for a refresher rather than lag.
Well, is he looking to use it to trap people more than to do damage?
There's a potential.
But I mean, the only people that traps is Pugna.
Yeah, that's the problem.
And trapping Pugna's not actually the smartest idea when your team's main damage is melee.
Radiant's top tower is under attack.
Basher finished on anti-mage. He needs to save for buyback though. He's really crucial to the next couple of fights.
He's gonna blink out. I mean, Bell getting all the time they need to farm up here.
I mean, I think Investors should be pushing. They should be going as 3 or 4 with the Shadow Blades and the Ghostwalk into the jungle and just punishing anyone who comes out. They're taking their time, they want to get the big core items up on the team. Like, Doom's finished up his heart, Voka's got his eggs, Shaman going for Refresher. But there's not really any need, they can just...
Yeah, a bit surprised that Shaman didn't pick up GG Boots first.
I suppose there's not that much need for them. I mean, they're comfortably winning fights still, and Guardian Greaves only really removes the mana cost for the healing part. They're both just gonna TP next to Pugna, but nothing they can do.
Well, it's a cleanse.
It looks like anti-mage has been ratted.
Radiant's bottom tower is under attack.
Rupture just no good against this fight, man. Blobs up crazy, getting doomed at bottom. Oh, the speed, he's on him, alright. No blink.
Yeah, he'll be going down.
Dead.
What do you think would be in a better mid hero than Quap this game? Something like maybe Windranger?
It's the only other real option they had was the Windranger, but it was banned out, right?
Windranger was banned out, to be fair, yeah.
Well gotten gains.
I mean, Invoker, OD. Silencer.
Of course OD, but Silencer would have been interesting. That might have changed things. Where did Void die?
Radiant's top tower.
Looked like they just shadowed over that to kill them.
I think it was at the side shop. I just watched a fight there. Top tower.
Radiant structures are fortified.
Here we got a TP.
Radiant's top tower is under attack. Dire's bottom tower is under attack.
He's gonna get so much damage.
He's actually gonna get the tower. He's gonna get the tower.
Radiant's top tower is
fallen.
Well, they should not have let that happen. Looks like they're gonna trade towers, potentially ranks. I don't know, with the Invoker TPing back, he's not gonna be in this fight.
Did throw in the
I'll steal three.
Not much damage, but they're still going to get something out of it. Probably.
Void's going to get up. And they finally take down the Doom as well. That's so big.
Pay for thy lack.
So they got a tower for a tower, and they traded 4 for 1.
That was a really big throw there from Invested. I think. The fact that Invoker had to TP back, and then Anti-Mage just TPs up top and ends the fight, really. Like, they should not have fought without Invoker, though. Big mistake. And now that's going to be a lot of core items finished up for Bell Gaming. That's going to be Ags for the Void. Ags for Pugna. Quap sitting on 2.5k gold. And probably another set of towers, if not racks at this point.
Radiant's middle tower has fallen.
Double G waiting along with Shadow Shadow.
Radiant's bottom tower is under attack.
Heart picked up for anti-mage now. His illusions will be very tanky indeed.
Radiant's bottom tower has fallen.
So, Abyssal into Skadi for anti-mage.
Skadi?
Oh, Skadi, no, I'm thinking Silencer. Never mind, yeah, it won't. He changed Silencer's pure damage attack to not being a
I've rarely seen carry Silencer. That'd be pretty cool. Skadi Silencer, I'm a fan. Lion Axe as well. This is what I was talking about at the start. If Void hits those Chronos and Lion hits those those, you know, 2-3 man finger of death, that's so much damage.
Once he finds level 16, it's like a 20-second cooldown.
Yeah, it's so strong. I'm inclined to believe that Bell Gaming actually has the upper hand now.
Oh, absolutely. I mean, even if you look at the XP charts, which actually is just zeroed out, Bell Gaming have managed to take a 12k lead from Invested Fame to zero it down in the last 12 minutes or so. Net worth wise, it's about 7.5k.
Do you want to void up top? Looks like he's going to get a nice pickup for Doom.
Easy kill for Invested Fame there.
They should just have warded their jungle a long time ago. It's a mistake.
Yeah, it's pretty greedy.
This next rush might turn the fight.
Hags on Lion. Yeah,
2 minutes. 2 minutes till the next rush, so that's going to be the turning point for this game. Whoever controls Roche, I reckon, with the cheese, stands a really good chance of winning now. And at the moment, Invested still have better map control with all these Shadow Blades and the Ghost Walk. Looks like they're making it a priority as well to just... Yeah, upgrade with the wall.
Double damage mid. Not bottom even.
They really want this rush. They're making sure it's a priority for them.
Totally spotted out though by those wards from Bell Gaming.
Big push coming out now with Void down. He doesn't land by that.
They don't want to wait till Roche is up.
Tornado on court.
Oh, wards are up.
Dire's middle tower has fallen.
Dire's middle tower. Not sure what they can do here with the Bloodseeker DD. If they jump in now, they're going to get insta kill. Rob strong anti mage just to zone him. And that's a free set of wrecks without Void.
God's right on nothing left.
I mean, it goes to show the only source of initiation that Bell Gaming has is the Void.
Well, I mean, if
Roche up in 30 seconds.
Gets like a, I don't know, the Lincoln's finished, then they'll be able to use her to an extent.
Yeah.
She'll die, but, you know, might get 2 or 3 kills out of it.
I think Lion should have just fingered them then.
Yeah.
She's just driven them away. Roche is going to be up in the next 6 or 7 seconds then.
Maybe he's just going to get that.
Bash crop to that. Oh my goodness, look at that timing. She blinked out the instant Roche spawn.
Yeah, I saw it.
That's going to suck for them. They're going to... That's really horrible.
Boom 6 actually got 2 Aether lenses on Rags.
Wow, that is, I guess it's just for the damage, really.
Yeah, it's only for the damage. Oh, regen as well, I guess.
Yeah, it's decent.
He is
regen.
Got by the, no, he's moved, dude.
A blinker or 4-stuff would have been better, I think. Just to save the people you get for, just to save the people who get doomed, for instance, or the guys who get shackled.
Yeah, he can just, heal them up. Instant cooldown though with the arc, so.
Bloodseeker Illusion is spawning out the rush, so looks like they're all gonna rotate over there in a minute. Hex on Ursa, so that's a really big pickup again.
That's really beardy. I mean, it sorts out his mana regen issues. And yeah. Got some spam his abilities all day, as well as being able to use the Shadow Blade. And also.
I mean, right now, this is Void. This is Void's worst nightmare. With the Shaman Hex and the Ursa Hex. If they target him carefully, then... I mean, they need to just go in and pick him off before he can chrono. And then I think their fights are going
to
be one. Looks like they're just going to walk in, basically, under Shadow Blade. Give it to the Ursa to do solo.
Yeah, well, it's not going to take him long.
Bell Gaming roots up at the Shadow Drop. Void's looking for the chrono. And team Mage up on the higher ground as well. Are they gonna let Garrosh go? No way.
They're gonna try and steal it.
Oh, they found him. Chrono? Oh, no. Void silenced up already.
Oh, this is bad.
And that's gonna be the end for Bell game. 2 down, Roche and cheese available. They're just leaving the cheese. Okay.
Alex was finished on Faceless before that fight as well.
They're gonna look to end now. Yeah. With Void no buyback, Quap no buyback, I think this is at least another set of rocks.
There's no creep at the base, right?
Pretty sure they can backdoor it. Or do Monto anti mage, so they can't save him. Just buying time for Void, 30 seconds for Void. They're gonna take out anti mage. He's got buyback, he uses buyback.
Oh yeah, buyback from Void. He tries to take Void direct with the ult, doesn't quite do enough damage. There is obviously Doom to go down here. Poker back up after the Aegis, he's just gonna back though. The Ward doing serious damage.
Anti mage looking for more. He's gonna blink up, not quite in range.
Shadow Shaman, can he shark one?
Oh, looks like. No, no. First it bash invoke. Is there a hex from Lion?
Which one's the real one? Oh,
stuck in the trees behind him. Invoker's going down.
Real misplays by Sour BA there. He had wards up, he had shackles up, he had hex up.
Consider thyself purified.
Yeah, a bit of panic, I think. And there's still the cheese in the pit as well. I wonder if they'll notice this. There's no reason for them to go into the Roche pit, but just cheese on the ground, man.
It's
it makes me sad.
Gold, you know.
Well, it's 500 gold, but like, no, I fucking collect cheese. Really? Oh my goodness.
Yeah.
And he may just gonna put. He's going for the top racks, I guess, but yeah, there should be backdoor, so I don't think
he's... Radiant's there.
I mean,
there will be backdoor, there's... Oh no, there is. There was creep, but there will be backdoor now.
He's just gonna get the hell out of
it. Yeah, racks gonna heal a fool.
Alright, wanting to fight. One more click! Oh the hex timing!
The hex from Ursa. He doesn't want to mess with the Chronosphere that's off cooldown.
He should have chrono. It's 60 second chronos, it's worth.
Yeah, just hesitant, I guess.
Just go for these racks. Doom's coming in though. Doom event. Oh no.
Furious.
Radiant's bottom tower is under attack.
2 minutes without Doom.
It's a long time.
Octarine Core just about finished on Invoker, the 400 gold chart. Wow, let's buy back.
Initiation onto Void, silence to the nothing to follow
Lion's
up.
Right in the oh, his stun only finds one.
Lion's going down, he's sort of...
Well, Seeker just stood there.
Chrono on 3, Chrono on 4. Nice swap on. But Anti-Mage is calling the Chrono, this is what I was talking about at the start. Nice
loot, mate. Tried it out there, just not enough mana gone yet. What's Seeker?
Quap's gonna get.
Seeker
looking to fight anti mage.
Double G here though.
Invoker coming in. Nicely done from Bloodseeker, just baiting him out with the.
And there comes the Sunstorm. Bloodseeker, one final right click just to take him out. But I mean, top is in a little bit of trouble. Are they going to end now? Let's push for throne.
No buybacks in any of the dire, so this should be thrown if they want. Yeah, it looks like they're just gonna go mid and end.
Radiant's top barracks are under attack. Dire's middle tower has fallen.
Well, Pugna manages to pick off Ursa. So. It's just
Lion's
a shit.
Up there as well.
Dire's middle tower. It's a lot of damage onto Invoker.
Ancient now exposed.
Buyback for Pugna. He's the only one with buyback though. Void up in 8 seconds if he can delay. Nah, that's it. GG well played.
Radiant
wow,
victory.
That was a tough fought battle.
Yeah, nice solid game from both teams. I don't think the Quap had enough impact in the early game and There were several times you just blinked in and look at the Lincoln Spear pick up there. It's just too late.
She died a few times. This what seemed really foolishly, and Auntie Mage kind of did the same. I mean, 6 deaths on Auntie Mage is quite a lot of deaths. Pugna managed to get less deaths off them.
He managed to stay on top of net worth, but it's just not enough. Not enough against that team. I mean, they picked Auntie Mage second, so obviously the Bloodseeker counter comes out. The Urs of the Doom.
On
to game 2.
Yeah, on to game 2. So Invested Fame take the first game in the best of 3 between Invested Fame and Bell Gaming. Join us in about 5 minutes and we'll have game 2.